So here's a quick video on TDR NOVA EQ. It's a free plugin. I think it's probably one of the best free plugins that you can use for a recorded metal guitar tone, and I'll show you guys why. So I prepared a track already, but we'll go through bit by bit just to give you a better idea of the plugin. So I've recorded a track already. It's pretty basic, but just to give you an idea, this is the DI sound. So chuggy, quite straightforward, and we'll add an amp to this. I'll use the Omega Granophyre from Neural DSP. And we'll just use out the box, first preset. I'm actually not going to touch anything at all, and this is what it sounds like. So it's quite boomy, and you know, there's a lot of bass kind of build up, and this is where TDR NOVA can really help. And we can use the EQ in two ways. So I'm first going to use it to EQ the DI, or at least this, the guitar signal going into the amp, to clean things up a bit. And I'm also going to use it after the amp to make things, I guess, more balanced and better sounding overall, at least to my ears. So we'll start by adding NOVA in front of the amp. And this is what you'll see when you get the plugin. So very basic. So if I play it now, you'll notice something. It's as if no signal is appearing here. And that's because you have to turn on the, spectograph. So you click the in button up here, and now it should appear. So there we go. What I'm going to do first off is cut some lows going into the amp so that we tighten things up on the lower end. So to do this, we can click the high pass filter here, and then we see we have this slope on the EQ. I would suggest going for 12 dB per octave roll-off, so that means how steep this roll-off is. And I'll play it now, and we'll play around this, and you'll hear the difference. So moving up. So obviously this is too high, but you hear the difference that it makes on the low end, or at least how clear the guitar comes through. I like to keep a value of around 80. So that's what we're going to go for here. Which helps quite a bit. And what we can also use this for is actually as a boost. So we can boost the signal with the out gain, or can also boost certain EQ parts to give a different sort of tone. So for example, I will use this band. So I'll click on number 3, and we'll just pick a mid EQ, and I'll boost this, for example. I'll let it play and you'll see the difference. That's obviously very extreme. You're probably not going to boost to that amount, but maybe that's the tone you're going for. So we can say keep this around that kind of level, and we can play around with the frequency to find something we like. And also with using the Q control, you can specify how specific, so thin the peak is, or how broad it is, so how much of that area of frequency you're going to boost, which can be quite helpful if you're trying to boost, say, more in the treble region or the high mids and things like that. So let's try with a broader EQ, so something like this, so 0.55. And then I'll keep this at 10 and we'll move this around and see what it does to the tone. So I quite like that. So I'm going to leave it there. And we've also got the out gains, or the output level of the EQ going into the amp, which we can also boost. So leaving this on, and I'll play with this. This is what we get. So this is over the top, but you really hear what's happening in sort of the bass area, that kind of buildup that's getting really muddy and obscuring the tone almost. And it's a lot more apparent as well when you combine it in a mix, which is what we'll see a bit later. So I'll zero this out, and we'll go to the second part of TDR Nova using that after the amp. So we'll close this one, and we'll add another instance after the amp. We hit the in button to turn that on, the spectrogram on, or spectograph. And there we see this is the area that we're going to try and target to pull down, or at least to control, because that's where that sort of buildup is present, and it's going to muddy up your mix. So by controlling that, we can add more clarity to chugging, I guess. So this is a setting that I quite like. So we set this around, well, I'll say 150, and relatively broad Q level to begin with. And this is where Nova is really amazing, considering it's free. It's dynamic, so there's a compressor that you can apply per band, or a dynamic EQ point. So in this case, we're going to activate by clicking on threshold. And it's, I guess, like the Andy Sneap trick that's been talked about a lot on the web. And the settings for this, or the ones I would suggest, would be an attack of 10 and a release of 25. Sorry, my keyboard's bugging out. A ratio of 4. And for the threshold, I'll let it play, and then I'll pull the threshold level down, so you'll see how it's affecting the band, and then you'll get an idea of what we're doing. So there, it's affecting quite a lot, and I think our Q level is probably too broad, but you hear what it does to the tone in that it clears up that sort of build-up. So the chugs are a lot clearer, and that makes a big difference when you're looking at it in a mix. So I'll just tighten this Q up a bit, because we don't want it to be affecting all the way over here, for example, with the EQ. So we'll tighten up the Q, I'll let it play, and we'll try and keep it to this kind of area, so between 100 and maybe up to around the 300 area. So that's pretty good. And what we can also do after the amp is that we can add high pass and low pass, or a high cut and a low cut, to clean things up even more. I would suggest also here going for a 12 dB per octave slope. And we can use the same figures as before. So an 80 on the low, and then on the high cut, I would suggest going for 10,000, which is quite a nice value, I think, and also like a 12 dB roll off. And that's what we get. And that's all with one plugin that's free. So we can use it to shape the guitar tone going into the amp. And we can also use it to control and EQ the signal after the amp. And this dynamic feature is especially useful for controlling chugs and making things clearer. So hopefully this was useful for some of you out there. As always, use your ears, experiment, don't be afraid to push levels, say going into the amp, try crazy EQ stuff, because you're not really going to harm a plugin in doing that, so you might as well try out some crazy experiments in terms of, say, boosting before a plugin or a guitar amp. You might find something that you really enjoy, and hopefully the multi-band compressor style dynamic EQ is useful for you in your productions after the amp. Thanks.